was that sound? Oh, these guys. Yeah, these guys are cool.
Yeah.
These guys are cool. Don't drown. Oh, boy. Yeah, bugs. You like bugs? Yeah, me too. Time to do a little exterminating. So obviously the walls are a little bit safer in terms of having some footing, but you don't want to get near them, otherwise you get spiked. You know, if we could just not get that, that would be really cool. Let's just not get that. I don't want to deal with Oko right now. Oh man, that's cool too, yeah. You like the skulls and the cloth embedded into that? Yeah, that's safe. Woo! Hero of Time's done with this crap. There's also a little way over there. I'm kind of curious about that. Because it seems like there's nothing there, which would make me think there's something here. Or there's not. Maybe that was just like a way to get hearts or something in regular mode. Alright, cool. You guys. Yeah, you guys. Can I just kill you before you even get up? Apparently not. There goes the fairy. Can I get like one more bottle? I'd love just like an extra third bottle. And while you're at it, give me a fourth bottle. Bottles are cool. I like bottles. Okay, that's... I like it. That's back in the room of spinny death. Good room. Good room. I like it. Who designed the spinny room of death with the spikes? Yeah. Good level design. I don't know anything about level design. Yeah, let's put some spinny spikes in there. If we could not with the bugs. Yeah, I like bugs. Okay, this should be the mini boss room. I'm recognizing this now. Because in here, we're going to have the item we can finally use to you know, beat up this dungeon. Oh no. We're locked in. Oh man, that's pretty spooky. What's the first thing Link does when he sees a sword covered in rope and what I assume to be like runes of some sort? Yeah, let's cut it. Make it angry. Man, the demon sword. Locked away here for millennia. You got any great ideas, Midna? Use your senses to find enemies you can't see with your eyes. So that's your hint. Find out there's actually a guy attached to this sword. Your first real chance at a battle where you have to use your senses to see the enemy. It's cool, I like it. I don't know if we necessarily have to be in a wolf form anymore. It's not giving me a lock on though. That's fun. We don't have to, like... Oh, do we have to bounce back the projectiles? Is that a thing for now? Can't do anything about an enemy circling in the air while you're in beast form. Yeah. This is supposed to take advantage of the fact that now... having the ability to switch between a human and a beast is really useful. That is not what I wanted to do. Do we have to shoot you? Maybe that's what we do. Oh, hey, look at that. That's cool. They input a, like, context-sensitive button-ish thing. So you can switch to between regular and bomb arrows. That's cool. I like that. Oh, good. It's doing that again, aren't you? I do like the enemies that you have to switch between the forms, though. It's kind of... it's a neat little thing. It's made a whole lot better by the fact that you can just switch at will like this. Rather than having to go through a menu. You can't just press the switch link button. I will say they did some nice things here with the HD version, just adding in all these like extra little shortcut buttons and stuff. Those actually make a good difference, I think. Just in terms of the playability, you know, nice little shortcuts like that keep you from having to access the menus often. Good things. Always a nice thing when you don't have to dig through a menu to grab an item. Alright, let's collect our reward. Haha. That was supposed to have a heart in it, but it didn't. So you notice we committed a fatal error here. We unfortunately cannot jump up here, so if whatever is in this chest isn't able to get us out of here, we're stuck in here forever. And that would be a tragic way for the Hero of Time to go. Be something good. Hey, you got the spinner! This ancient machine allows you to float in the air. Can use it to move over sand, and I think on rails, is what they said. So the spinner, I like the spinner. I think the spinner is one of those really weird items that works really well. It does a couple things, but it does a couple things really well. So, you get on top of it, you have limited movement left and right, and over time it slows down. When it runs out of speed, you just get off. It also can't go upstairs. It can go up ramps, but not really stairs. So if you press the button, it'll do a little spin, which is useful for a number of things. It's an attack of some sort, or a stun. I think it's an attack, though. It also allows you to jump, like that. And like I said, when you run out of spin, it stops, but when you're on a rail, you don't actually run out of spin, so... and keep going. It's a gadget, really, and I really like it. Just because it's so cool, and there's quite a little bit of fun you can have with it. So anyway, you get to see now the spinner in action. Use it to spin. We've got quite a couple things in Hyrule that we're going to be using it for. Mostly just to, like, get puzzles and stuff like that. It's not really a battle-type weapon like the arrow or the claw shot can be. It's more of a... just sort of a... mobility slash something else. I don't know. I should have not have come down here, so we're actually going to go back. Don't know if it actually makes your movement speed any faster than normal running. Certainly not once it slows down, so more than likely no. No, for one thing, you can get rid of bugs with it. There we go. I was supposed to stay up here because there's a track here that I can ride on. So you can transfer from one rail to another. You can also go over those death pits that we've been having to avoid. That's another cool thing about this. So it'll help us get through all the sand area pretty well. We do have to be careful of those spike guys. Those spike guys will still be a problem for us. And this is so cool. That's why I really like this dungeon. They built it entirely around this cool spinner mechanic. That's another reason why it's so fun. It's such a great item is that they built a good dungeon around it. There's a piece of heart. Oh man, I couldn't have waited to get hurt until then. I could have gotten all those hearts back. Don't get hit by the spikes. Don't get hit by the spikes. These cool little puzzles you can do with it. Isn't it fun? Oh, whoops. Going the wrong way. Trying to turn the other way. Oh, I succeeded for a moment. There we go. Who came up with the design for this room? They need a raise. Find whoever, find whoever came up with the idea of ghost rats. Take his raise away and give it to the guy who made this room, because this is a cool room. There we go. Yeah. I'm gonna attack myself. It's good. Yeah. Suck it, enemies. Please don't be a stamp. I have a dreadful feeling that that was a stamp. Okay. This is going to teach us about avoiding spike guys. They will knock you off if you run into them. So you want to avoid that. Man, that's such a cool room, isn't it? So fast, so much. Oh, hey there. Big key already. Just going to destroy this dungeon now. Because of this. Oh. Now, I did say that, you know, we won't fall with this thing, but at the same time, I don't know if there's really a way out of here. Other than, you know, death. Eternal solitude, as it were. In normal circumstances where you can actually get out, that's helpful. Also, once you're in the sand, you can't actually pull out the spinner, so you have to activate the spinner before you get to the sand. Anyway, I think there actually was some more treasure in here. Let me get that really quick and we'll come back to this room. It's mostly incidental stuff, so I'm gonna cut really quick. I'm glad I skipped that. There actually wasn't anything left. I thought there was, but apparently not. Anyway, we're now in a spinner puzzle. By tapping the spin button, Link does his best dance routine. And we're able to power very large gear-based structures. I was for sure I heard like a creepy sound there. Ah, yes. This room looks dangerous. I like it. Yes, low rotation. Yeah, let's try that again. Quickly notice that the stairs are out, but fortunately someone left a cool track here for us to just skip around. I think I remember how this goes. Hold on, let's keep going. Yeah, I remember how this goes now. So anyway, we get to the top here and we're kind of left with a blocked off structure. Which, if the stairs' entire point was to get us up to here, which looks like that was its porpoise. Oh, hey there. Hold on, let's grab that. There we go. The entire purpose of the stairs was to go up to the top and have nothing there. It's a little odd, I have to say. Not the first odd thing. Okay, cool. So let's go back. Ah, yes, there we go. That's what you want. Dance, Link, dance! Dance your pants! Light the fire with the power of dance! There you go. Alright, so that, yeah. So that's where that leads. We're gonna go back up. I just wanted... I'm always curious if, like... If you go the wrong way on puzzles, if you get... You know, a secret or something. Oh man, boss room already. Oh, we're only like an hour in. This was a fast dungeon compared to usual. Alright, let's go. This boss is pretty cool. I like this guy. Yeah, this dungeon, once you got the mid boss like item, it was pretty much done. Just, you know, run through a couple of rooms and you're done. Okay. So we got some spooky bones. Not really an enemy per se. It's kind of a relic of a hunted creature. Oh, and Zant! Oh no, you still live. How astonishing. No wonder some call you hero, but this is truly a bittersweet reunion. Bittersweet, truly, for I fear this is the last time I'll see you alive. Please stop skipping my text, Aunt. I want to read it. Cool. He's all like, I'll take my leave. You deal with the resurrected bone skeleton. Twilight fossil. Star-Lord. So, in case you can't tell from the smoking weak points, there's a weak point we should be trying to hit. And all this is quicksand in here, by the way, so we'll want to keep moving. There's also this cool rail here to keep us moving, though there are spikes around the area, so we have to be careful about those. Gotta be careful about that. Actually, I don't think this is quicksand, because we're allowed to get out of it. Whew. Oh yeah, so these guys, their only purpose is to block me from getting to his spine. So you've gotta find the hole in them if you can. Oh man, yeah, and they're rough when you get close. They also do this really cool thing as well. We're in this room for some reason. I'm not sure why. I don't think it's ever really explained with a reason. But for some reason, your length of time you're allowed to spin before having to... Before having to, you know, restart your spin is a lot shorter than usual. I'm doing really bad. I think you can take them out with a spin. You just... Dang it, come on! I don't remember there being that many spikes on these. Well, here's that. There are a lot of spikes over here. Come on. Get out of my way! Dang it. Spinning, I don't believe, actually makes your, makes you go any faster or anything. Yeah, it doesn't. As much as I'm complaining about it, this is a really cool boss battle, is it not, though? Oh, there wasn't a good way out of that one. There we go. That was rather easy. You'd think for like a giant, you know, evil beast, hitting his, I don't know, his spinal cord three times wouldn't work. I mean, of course that might work on a human, but you know, on an undead skeleton, bro? You think... I don't know. Just seems like a little easy, I have to say. Oh well. Dance, dance, dance! Oh no, who would have guessed he wasn't actually dead? Because we didn't hear the music, didn't get a heart container. And we opened up a big room full of spinny spike trap, or spinny track things. Alright, this is when it gets interesting. So the middle track is a elevated, or... It goes upwards as you spin on it. There's a little bit of... You gotta be careful, I guess. We'll see in a second. He's gonna shoot attacks at us, which we can only avoid by doing that. And he gets close enough and bam! Right in the kissing. Go for the sword. Alright, let's go. I don't know, I like this battle, it's fun. Oh yeah, now they pull out the spikes. So now it's gonna take us even longer to get up. I think there's some kind of... There's something you have to do to make this work. There you go. Whew. A little hot in here. They're very forgiving with how you land these jumps. I've got an idea. I've always wondered if this would help me. All right, extra damage. Can we two-cycle him? Yes, we can! Two-cycle. There you go. I was wondering if that would work. Some of the enemies in this game, you do seem to be able to cycle faster if you do enough damage, which, jump attacks, I think, do more damage than a regular sword swing, I think. I don't really know, they just seem to. Wow, Link, that could have killed us. You should have been really more careful about that. Which is kind of ironic, considering that it dropped a heart. All right, let's go. We're close to the Mirror of Twilight. All right. What are we at now? Is that 10? 10 hearts. That is going to be very useful. Now we're at the point where I can actually make use of all those higher tier health products. Yeah, let's save. We're going to do a little bit more. And then we'll stop, because this actually... Normally, these dungeons take about an hour and a half, which is what I was planning to spend. But that... We rushed through that in about an hour. It might have helped that I did a tiny bit of the dungeon before we stopped. Oh, okay. Don't mind me, just little gaps. No danger. The mirror chamber. Well, that looks like something we could use our new item on, doesn't it? Oh, curses! Just kidding. This is actually super useful. Be able to teleport back here instead of having to, you know, take giant cannon route. Alright, so we got 5 enemies to deal with now. And a bat. What are you bats doing here? Get out. Oh. Ah. I don't know what the bats were doing here. I want to say they were here to confuse me. Keep me on my toes. There we go. I just don't know why you keep sending these enemies after me. Their only purpose seems to be to help me and not help you. Assuming Xant sends them, or maybe like an underling, you know, unpaid intern doesn't get quite the recognition he deserves, so he's actually trying to make Xant do worse off. Tired of all the crap he's got to deal with? Come on, Link, dance! You guys normally just hide that, you know, in the dirt, under the sand? Oh, look at those chains. Oh, that's bad. That's 7 years of bad luck right there. It's broken. Mirror of Twilight's broken. This is even an evil mirror, right? So that's gotta be even more than 7 years of bad luck. Oh boy, yeah, let's get weird again. Yeah, these guys are weird. Look, they got detached face masks. A dark entity lurks in the twilight. It houses an evil power. You who are guided by fate, you who possess the crest of the goddesses, hear us. At the command of the goddesses, we sages have guarded the Mirror of Twilight since ancient times. You seek it, but the Mirror of Twilight has been fragmented by mighty magic. Look, their hands float too, they're weird. That magic is a dark power that only he possesses. His name is... Ganondorf. Oh, it's Ganondorf. Okay. Yeah, you thought Ganondorf wasn't a part of this game? No, he is. He was the leader of a band of thieves who invaded Hyrule in the hopes of establishing dominion, something I think about the Sacred Realm. He was known as a demon thief, an evil magic wielder renowned for his ruthlessness. Also for having sick horse skills while there's fire in the background. But he was blind. So we got him glasses. In all of his fury and might, he was blind to any danger, and thus he was exposed, subdued, and brought to justice. Angry faces. Yet. Oh no. Curse you, Triforce, for making everything just a little bit more difficult. By some divine prank, he too had been blessed with the chosen power of the gods. Not my brother. And only his floating face was left. How tragic. His abiding hatred and lust for power turned to purest malice. Perhaps that evil power has been passed on to Zant. You're just now figuring out where Zant got his power? It's far too late. Only the true leader of the Twilight can utterly destroy the Mirror of Twilight, so Zant could merely break it into pieces. Once broken by magic, the Mirror of Twilight became fragments which even now lie hidden across the land of Hyrule. One is in the snowy mountain heights. Told you we were going there. One is in an ancient grove. And one is in the heavens. You who have been sent by the goddesses, you should be able to gather the three pieces. But you must be prepared, for a dangerous power resides in those fragments. Well, that's not a new thing. So yeah, that sounds like a quest for us. It's always nice to have an adventure that isn't entirely centered around Ganondorf being the bad guy. I mean, he is a bad guy, so it's not like he isn't here, you know. But it's always nice to have it where he isn't the only bad guy. Also, I was gonna walk back, and I realized that's probably not the best way to go about that. But I actually don't know the right way to go. tell you the truth. You know what? Yeah, we'll stop here. That was the extra little bit I wanted to get done. And we'll look more into that next time, but I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time for some more Twilight Princess HD. Bye!